Everybody don't need a podcast, man.
Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the Friday episode of DRH. R. Kelly is not performing at the Grammys this year, and we're going to tell you why.
Bambi's blood is super real now.
And if you work for YouTube, you might have PTSD.
Stick around for the third trimester. We buy a WNBA team. It's the Atlanta Dream, baby.
That's right. Let's jump in. Utah Racial.
Makes me giggle every time.
Who's this?
This is Roe James.
Roe James, okay.
It's a solid joint.
Perfect way to end off the week.
Yeah, dude.
Right into the sunset.
Happy week's end.
What's up, everybody? It's DRH Friday, baby.
Or whenever you're listening, because whenever you're listening is the right time.
We're here, we're queer.
Been queer.
And we're in your ears.
Nice.
Dark Racial Humor, episode 108. What's up, everybody? Friday, January 24th. It's Dark Racial Humor, free-flowing end of conversation about whatever's appropriate at the time with your friends, Bon, Jen.
Caller John, David, Richard, coming to you live from South Los Angeles in Adobe House.
Yeah,
it's the best episode yet. Really glad you're on board and ready to get trained on.
Yeah, yes. What?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so it's Friday. Congratulations. You made it through the week.
Made another day, not dead yet, dude.
That's right. I got to work tomorrow and Sunday, so it feels like a Sunday night to me. But I'm happy to be here, so, you know, we're just... That was a very good use of that.
Nice, dude.
That was solid.
How was your day?
My day was chill. It was the day off. Woke up, look in the mirror, and I was like... You know what? I've achieved the look. It's time for something new. Chopped off the hair.
Oh, shit, dude.
Yeah. And then I went to the beach.
Wow.
And, yeah.
It was... You let the new ends of your hairs get the old sun rays?
Yeah.
From whenever they emanated from the sun?
It was cool. Yeah, it was cool. Even though I wore a hat.
Yeah.
It was chill. I remember... I was looking in the mirror, I was like doing it, and I was super scared, so fucking scared. And then I heard the fucking crunch of the blade on my luscious locks.
Yeah.
And I was like, fuck, this is it, not going back. And then I kept snipping, and I was like, wait, I look pretty good. And then I just saw that shit off, and I was like, why didn't I do this months ago?
Yeah.
So, you know, pretty chill day. And now I'm potting.
Yeah.
Yes, how was your day?
Fine, dude. Woke up at 11, read some book, went downstairs, tried to edit the fuck out of a pod, drank some coffee, got anxious and frustrated because of a technical error with the pod, realized what was wrong, fixed it, solution oriented in this bitch.
Yeah.
You know what it is.
What was wrong?
The last episode had the wrong audio, so when trying to line it up to the video, it was incorrect, so I was like, maybe it's the wrong trimester, but it was just altogether fucked up.
Yeah, that's probably my bad on that one. I'll take the L on that one. I probably named it something different.
Yeah.
Or exported the wrong thing, or, you know, excuse me. Oh, God. Where the fuck are my manners?
Let's jump into it, dude. Do you want some live action movie, some politics, some Grammys?
Some live action movie?
Yeah.
Sure, let's start there.
We, you know, everybody's favorite murder flick, Bambi, is getting a live action remake, and
it's about time. Is it for theaters or for Disney Plus?
I don't know. That's a good question.
Are they going to use real blood?
They're going to use real people, actually.
Really?
They're actually going to shoot a deer because you can't. It's not appropriate in 2020 to fake that stuff anymore.
I've never seen Bambi.
I don't think I really have either.
Is it going to be like?
It was kind
of
old.
A flop. I think it was one of the first Disney animated films. I think Snow White was the first.
I think I've seen Snow White.
I haven't seen Snow White. I've seen that old shit.
1942.
Damn.
That is old.
It's almost 100 years old.
That's the 40s, dude. An animated movie in the 40s.
They must have really loved it.
It was probably the best thing ever, dude.
Yeah.
First scene was just a fucking snuff.
Walt Disney invented the thing where, like, you would put the animated fucking frames on like glass planes and the camera would zoom, or like the glass would like separate from each other so it looked like you're zooming into the animation.
Damn.
Yeah, it looks wild. And they used it for Star Wars too.
Damn. Star Wars?
Yeah, the old Star Wars. So is this gonna be like, are they gonna change the story up?
And Bambi comes back for revenge?
Well, I remember, let me guess who's directing this, Jon Favreau?
I think so.
Of course.
Let me see.
J.J. Abrams?
Yeah, the live action remake continues to pay off for Disney as the last two outings, Jon Favreau's Lion King and Guy Ritchie's Aladdin, were $1 billion grosses. I actually don't know who it's directed by.
I'm directing it.
Nice, dude. Yeah, nice.
You got the job.
That's a good gig, dude.
Dude, they called me. And Bob was like, yo, can we get dinner this Wednesday?
Yeah.
And I was like,
Bob, I have cancer.
Yikes. Apple joke. You got to read the book to get it. I was like, I can't make it. And he was like, fuck it. Do you want to direct Bambi? And I was like, how much? And he was like, $25,000. And I was like, are you kidding
you
me?
You mean for a minute?
I was like, wait, is that a joke? And he was like, bro, listen, I'm doing you a favor. No one knows who you are. This is going to gross over $1 billion. And if it hits that billion mark, you'll get 25%. I was like, deal, let's get it.
25%?
Yeah, so production starts in June. Yeah. And we're looking for a February 2021 release date.
Nice.
Hopefully, dude. If everything goes to plan.
Nice.
You know, but now what I was going to say, The Jungle Book.
Yeah.
Jon Favreau was saying, like, they changed, like, the morals of the story. Like, the original was about man, like...
fucking bears.
Fearing nature.
Yeah.
And
that's
new,
cool.
Yeah, the new one was about, like, man protecting nature.
Ah.
Yeah.
I think fearing is more... well, because I think the fear is more animal-based and then, like, the elemental-based. Am I on the right
vein? Yeah, it was something like, don't go in the jungle or you'll get eaten.
Yeah.
But now it's like, we got to protect animals.
Yeah.
I saw a new one. It was good. I think
the God-fearing of nature.
Yeah.
It's written by...
nature's scary.
Geneva Robertson Dworet of Captain Marvel and Lindsay Beer of Chaos Walking. Haven't heard of Chaos Walking. A director is yet to be decided.
Hollywood is just people giving their friends jobs.
I think that's most things.
It's like, hey, man. You wrote a pretty okay script in high school when we knew each other. Hop on this fucking pilot with me.
Release yet? Date is yet to be announced, but more updates are expected to arrive in the coming months, says Orlando Brown. He's a reporter now for the Hype. I'm reading off Hypebeast.
Orlando Brown of That's So Raven fame.
Yeah. And
Nick
Cannon.
Cannon.
Yeah, his dick.
Oh, right. All right. I wonder what Orlando Brown's up to.
I don't know how he gets money.
I saw I don't know if it was him. It was like a trailer for a Little Mermaid live thing. And I feel like Orlando Brown was in the commercial, like promoting it. But I couldn't tell if it was him or not.
That's funny.
Yeah. I was like, wait, there's no way he's working for Disney.
Damn.
After he like said he fucked Raven, first of all. And that other girl, Chelsea.
Chelsea's kind of attractive.
Yeah, dude.
Ousted Grammy CEO claims to have hard rock hard evidence. Her words, not mine. Rock hard dick evidence.
Yeah.
That award show is ripe with corruption.
Probably. I'm working the Grammys this weekend.
Are you?
Yeah.
Doing what?
Doing some tech something. Damn. For like a press event.
For what company?
For the store I work at.
Really?
Yeah. I went to go pick up my badge today and there are
for
a bunch.
For fucking the one that starts with A?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What a get.
I
what
know.
A gig, dude.
I know.
How'd they land the big guys?
I don't know. They did it last
That's
year.
Crazy.
Yeah.
A little bit crazy.
Kinda. It's
maybe
like
not.
It's like $7,000 the store's getting paid.
That
for the weekend.
Seems like
I don't get any of it,
not
but
a lot.
Yeah, it doesn't. Well, kinda. I don't know. But yeah, it's just the equipment they're like renting and then we gotta run it during like some event and
dope.
Kinda dope, but also 15-hour days.
I was gonna
two
ask.
Days in a row.
Gonna ask
fat money, but
over, I mean,
yes, super fat money, but
probably,
also,
I mean,
sleep? Like mental well being, like not being miserable. No, nah, I'm just kidding, it's gonna
sick
be cool.
Podcast, dude.
I went to go get my credential today, and uh-huh. There were signs everywhere that said, if you talk about this on social media or take a picture of it, you will be banned from the event. So, like, I probably shouldn't even be talking about this now, but
yeah.
No one listens to this, so who gives a fuck?
If it is caught, I think that's our big break. Dude.
Someone's going to pull me aside. Excuse me, sir. Are you Bonjen?
Oh, you watched the fucking pod?
Yeah, like, sick, yeah, so episode 108, 11:24 minutes in.
First of all, love the app. Solid episode.
Solid episode. Been a fan since April.
I got to do this to you.
Like it's my boss. It's above me. I'm sorry. You're great. Keep doing what you're doing.
I'd be more stoked someone listened that is like tied with the Grammys.
Yeah, I'd be like, yo. I don't know what I would say. I would be sad that I'm not working the Grammys. I'd probably just come home and chill. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. But what were you saying about the Grammys? Corruption.
Deborah Dugan or Duggan, D-U-G-A-N, is the first female to hold the role in 62 years. Recently went on Good Morning America with her attorney, Doug Wigder, to discuss, I don't know, the bombshell allegations she made earlier this week. On Tuesday, January 21st, Duggan filed a discrimination complaint against the Academy, alleging unlawful gender discrimination, sexual harassment, which is a fucking big allegation, unlawful retaliation, and unequal pay. Duggan says she has evidence the award show is ripe with corruption, which is kind of unrelated somewhat to the thing she's alleging?
Corruption? Oh.
Yeah.
What is corruption, though?
Let's see.
Can't she just say what they're being corrupt?
Now, by Deborah Dugan, along with her attorney, Doug Wigdor, thank you both for coming in.
Dougie.
This morning. Well, the battle's pretty well joined right here. Let's start where Amy left off. Those women on the executive committee said this is just not a boys' club.
Right. Well, when I came in as the first CEO of the...
First of all, she has a comically like high-pitched voice.
Academy.
Sounds like a cartoon.
Years female. There are definitely amazing, amazing people that work there in the Recording Academy and also on the board. But at the very onset, in fact, under the guise of a work dinner, I was propositioned by the general counsel, an entertainment lawyer of enormous, enormous power in the industry.
Mr. Katz.
Yes.
He categorically denies those allegations, says you got the dinner completely wrong.
Yes, well...
Katz is a board member, Joel Katz.
It probably is a boys' club.
Calling me babe and saying how
shit, it's the fucking Grammys.
Yeah.
Fucking outdated motherfuckers.
You know, the evening went on to, trying to kiss me. And all the way through, I felt like I was being tested in... How much would I acquiesce? And I realized
you're the CEO. I guess the board could vote you out, but like, you know,
that was
I think they did.
Our
yeah, you know,
move
some Weinstein power shit right there.
He looked like Weinstein.
Probably
right
true.
I mean, the statements that they're getting about
how
about
difficult would it be for like another fucking award show to like that's not the Grammys start and be like as fucking. well known as the Grammys.
Like, when did the Grammys start?
I don't know. Maybe that's why, because it's the oldest shit.
Probably.
Couldn't like Spotify like make a fucking award show or something?
It's a sicky.
Called the Spotties.
62nd annual. So that's like, I don't know.
Jesus presented the first Grammys.
Minus 62 is 1958, so the 60s. I don't know. That's a good question.
Also, is the Academy the same Academy as the Oscars? Are they all the same Academy? Is it all just 15 bald, fat, 90-year-old white guys listening to music that their granddaughters recommend and saying, oh, I kind of like this one. Let's I want this one to win. All right, what do you think, Earl?
Shit. Probably, bro. That's why no one fucks with it.
Yeah, dude, it's so fucking... But still, like, artists are like, yo, I just want to win a Grammy so I can say, yeah, I got the Grammy.
Like, is it even... It's one of those things where, like, a lot of people are like, yo, this is a bunch of bullshit. But then, like, 70% of their peers are like, yo, I got a fucking Grammy, motherfucker.
I've noticed that people only, with some exceptions, boycott and trash the Grammys if they've already won a Grammy.
Yeah.
Like Frank Ocean and Childish Gambino. They already had their moment in the sun, and now they're like, I don't need this shit.
I think, like, Tribe Called Quest hasn't got a Grammy. Grammy's music, right?
Yeah.
See, like, I don't even fucking
know. Will Smith doesn't have a Grammy. He trashed the Grammys back in the day.
Yeah. Like.
But it's easy to be like, yo, I already got a Grammy, man. Fuck the Grammys, bro.
Yeah. I mean, fuck.
Dude, yeah, like, I can't, like, people vote for it. Like, the Kids' Choice Awards.
Yeah.
Like,
let the kids vote, dude. So Lil Uzi and all them.
Well, Lil Uzi wouldn't be nominated.
Why not, dude?
Is he nominated this year?
I don't know.
All right, like,
do you want to look at record
of the year, and tell me who do you think, if like fucking everyone in the world voted, who do you think would win? Everybody in the world that cared.
First of all, who do you think is nominated? Record of the year.
Record of the year. I just know. I think Tyler the Creator is one.
Let us see the record of the year. So this is like a song.
Yeah.
Hey Ma by Bon Iver.
Okay.
I don't know what that is. Bad Guy by Billie Eilish.
Okay. I think that's going to win.
Seven Rings by Ariana Grande.
I think Billie Eilish is going to win still.
Hard Place by H.E.R.
That's the one.
Record really?
No.
Talk by Khalid.
Actually, maybe, I don't know, dude. Billie Eilish is,
Old Town Road.
Nah.
No?
Nah.
Not for a Grammy?
Actually, that would be interesting.
That, okay, had the most, like, cultural relevance.
Yeah, that, like, fucking did a lot for music, kinda.
Truth Hurts by Lizzo. And nah. Sunflower by Post Malone. You know why I think people like the Grammys? Because everybody loves to have a list and then pick one like we're doing right now and see what might win. It's very fun.
Except
it's real
we're
fun.
Getting paid for it.
Hello money. Hello money.
What to do with it. We have so much money.
So much.
Yeah, it's either fucking Bad Guy or Old Town Road. I think it's probably Old Town Road.
Watch Billy just clean up this year.
Billy, dude.
She's going to take like a picture on the red carpet holding like 8 Grammys. It's going to be one of those.
I haven't seen that music video yet.
And then Phineas is going to be like, this should be me. This should be me out there.
Dude, I mean, without his sister, he wouldn't have done anything. So, you know.
Well, you probably would have made the same songs, but no one would know it. Yeah.
I mean, no, you don't even have that voice.
Yeah. You think he was like, you better fucking sing like this. Like, he sings it exactly the way. What if she doesn't sing at all?
Damn.
He's in the back just fucking singing for her.
I'm a bad.
Yeah.
She's apparently very meticulous with how she's doing her vocals. Because it's super dry. It's not a lot of stuff. So the vocal is kind of a very, very big part of it.
Her vocals dry?
I mean, the whole production of the song.
Oh.
Like there's like three things. And then, like, if she doesn't get her syllables right with her goddamn retainer out. She was about to put that retainer in the beginning of that song.
What retainer?
There's an intro. Like, if you've seen the music video, like, I have my retainer out. My Invisalign is out now. And it's like her taking it out. It's like 7 seconds or whatever.
Like a sound of a retainer coming out of the mouth?
Yeah, and she's like, ah, now I have my Invisalign on, off, it can start. Just a little, like, fun intro, right?
That's disgusting.
She was going to put that at the beginning of the song. Why? And I think Phineas was like, nah, or her, one of them was like, nah, we shouldn't have that be subjected to people, so people would want to, like, listen to it.
Yeah.
So she put that in, like, the intro track before.
That's like starting a song. What? Like, I would be like, okay, next. Thank you, next. Oh god, alright. Yep. Alright, we're having too much fun. We'll be right back.
Second trimester shit.
What you know about that 2T?
That sticky icky icky.
Yo, we're here with Sticky Kalani.
You're sticky yourself. Kalani, how you smelling tonight, baby? God.
Kalani, right after a jog. straight into the studio, no shower.
Yo, welcome to my new artist name, Kalani after a shower.
Post Malone
after a jog.
Post Malone's in there waiting. He's fresh. He's fresh out the basketball court. Oh god. Dark racial humor. Oh, it's a Friday episode, guys. We're having fun tonight. You know, we're here. You know, normally we would use Fridays to answer some viewer questions on our Instagram DMs. Do we have any?
Oh yeah, we got it. A girl from Idaho says, "Wow, you guys are my best friends." First of all, thank you for that. We love to be your friends on audio.
Feel like is this real or are you just saying?
No, this? She's from Idaho. Her name is Shirley.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hi, Shirley.
I shouldn't laugh at someone's name, but. Shirley says, thanks for, I feel like you guys are my best friends.
Really? Okay, that's great.
And she's been not a day one listener, but that's okay.
Hey, okay, well, I don't want to hear anymore. Fake.
You're right.
Stop listening. Unsubscribe. No, actually, hey, what's up, Shirley? Thanks for listening to the pod. Because of you, this is a little more.
It's 'cause of Rick.
Yeah, we get that
if
money.
You guys
thanks for listening to the ads. Don't skip them.
Rate and subscribe on Apple Podcasts. Means a lot.
Yeah, definitely do that. Actually, that should be your main priority before anything else. Leave a fucking review of Dark Racial Humor on Apple. Share that bitch on Twitter. Share that bitch on Instagram.
Instagram at Dark Racial Humor. Twitter, hashtag Dark Racial Humor.
Follow us on Insta, please. And also, you know, YouTube. We're on YouTube. Look up some clips.
Just type in Dark Racial Humor Podcast.
You got it, dude.
And you'll find something.
You'll find... Just, you might have to go to page 7 or 8.
No, but you'll find, I think, old episodes off top, for sure.
Yeah.
That has better... And go to adobehouse.live/store. Get our favorite shirts. Don't yawn on my pod.
Sorry.
You know, it's actually like... A thing where you have to continue to do it because now it's a part of the brand.
Was it? Yeah, don't yawn on my pod. No woman can love a man with a podcast.
Yeah.
Or if you're a woman that prefers the company of men, we have no man can love a woman with a podcast.
And also, no woman can love a woman with a podcast.
And also, no man can love a man with a podcast. We're covering all the bases.
No, they can't love
with a podcast. I don't know.
And we got to
put it on your blog.
Shout out to the bestiality. No woman can love a dog that has a podcast.
No woman should love a dog, first of all.
No woman should fuck a dog.
Yes. No. Maybe.
You should definitely fuck your dog.
Some dogs are cute. Some dogs
hot dogs. Hot. Second trimester.
We got a lot going on in the DMs.
A lot going on, dude.
Okay, yeah.
You know we have Carl and Ed coming out on Tuesday. Your favorite Bart Barker animation coming out. I think that's slated for Friday, but I'll talk to the team.
Right.
No, I'm getting word. It's Sunday. They're getting it in on Sunday.
Nice, dude.
I have a Bluetooth all the time. It's actually just a Bluetooth phone, and I tap. I say, "How you doing, Chuck? Have you seen Spice Adams?"
Yes.
The guy that's he's saying what now, Chuck? Old heads with Bluetooths Spice in the air. Adams. He's the big.
Is he the guy that's like
football player? Yeah.
Is he actually a football player?
He used to be. He used to just kill it on the Chicago Bears. You know,
Barry, now he's a meme.
He's not a meme. He's a fucking content orchestrator. Is how we like to call it. Fucking Barack Obama loves him because you know Bommy's a shy dude.
Yeah,
Shy Town. Oh, I got a third trimester song for sure.
Really?
I'll cue it up now,
dude. I just remembered I was at work yesterday.
Yeah,
setting up some equipment for this YouTube Music party Grammy thing.
Nice.
And fucking two guys from Brockhampton walked in.
They raped you?
Nah.
Tell your story.
They just came in and they were just standing.
They came
there.
In you? Tell me where.
They didn't come in me.
Okay.
No. They just walked in and I was like, whoa.
You guys are you.
I was like, that's cool.
Yeah.
Had to keep my cool because, you know, representing the fucking...
The A brand.
Yeah. But, you know, just went to the bathroom, cried a little bit.
Just people.
Came out.
Just people. They probably don't even contribute much to the music.
Dude, what was so fucking funny was one of the guys was fucking driving the shittiest car. And I was like, that's fucking great. I love that. It just literally just looked like he came from the fucking gym.
Yeah.
I was like, wow.
Because he was sweaty,
had a
like,
smoking girlfriend, though. Nice. I was like, dude, if you were not in this fucking group, not a chance. She was all over him, too. He looked so unhappy. Oh, God. It was funny, you know.
Damn, you're just spilling a lot of beans, dude.
Oh, fuck. I hope I get... No, I don't. I was going to say, I hope I get fired, but I don't want to get fired. I'd rather quit and get fired.
Yeah, that's right.
That's that
You
attitude.
Hold the leverage.
I got the leverage, dude. I've done a lot of shit. I should have been fired, like, a couple times.
Mm.
But, you know.
Yeah, we got them, boys.
God is good, you know. Keep the blessings coming.
Dude, imagine getting, like a charged with, like, heinous crimes. Just fucking multiple rapes, multiple murders. And you get acquitted somehow. And you say, you know, God's good.
Dude, that's kind of like our boy in Tucson with the dreads.
With the dreads?
H-Man. Hope.
Oh, yeah. But he only has non-hateful crimes.
He was like, scared he's going to go to jail. And he just got fucking...
He did.
There's like a moment where he like got off with parole for like a year and he was like, God is good. Thank
but
you
he's
so
always
much.
Been on the God tip.
Yeah.
Always been on.
You just got to stop committing the crimes, you know?
But I mean, hey, you got to do what you got to do.
I mean, yeah.
And when you do it, you got to pray even harder.
Oh, how about a guy? What a guy.
I love him, dude. I love H guy.
H guy's the man.
He already said his acronym of a name.
And his sister, ML.
ML. ML.
Yeah.
ML, I'm saying ML a lot, so I'm trying to, don't say it, I'm jogging my memory.
You got it, dude. Weird name, really weird name. Not even a name that I ever heard.
Got it. Yeah.
Yeah.
She's nice, too.
She's cool. Good people.
I bet their mother's really nice.
Yeah, I remember one time he was having a fight with his mom. He was real upset. Yeah. Can't fight with your mom. What else is going on?
Dude, we got some shit going down. In the politic world. The impeachment trial's been going crazy.
Yeah. It's heating up, folks.
Dude, if there's one thing I love watching on politics, it's trials, dude. And these trials, this fucking trial in particular, just 24 hours, literally, and it's fucking day-to-day. I'd be watching it at my job. My boss was like, you really in the fucking into this shit? And I was like, yeah.
Damn.
But
not been following it at all.
It's TBH. Yeah, it's kind of the evidence is what you would kind of assume. It's a lot of people are like phone calls and everything specific. I couldn't tell you because now I forget. But
you suck.
There is a tape of President Trump saying to get rid of the Ukraine ambassador, Yovanovitch. Say get rid of her, get her out. And so that's a lot of things, because one side is saying it's obviously the president's prerogative to get a ambassador out, but she was in there since like Reagan era, and she was allegedly like walking around like homie's gonna get impeached and shit, so he didn't like that. And now I think news outlets have a recording of him saying to people to oust lady. But it's pretty cool, dude. Schiff, who's the leader of the Democratic impeachment, council.
Yeah.
Had a dope closing statement. He really killed it with his speech. He was like, yo, homie's fucking not doing right stuff. And you gotta take an account for who his allegiances lie with, and that's only with him. It was a pretty good political speech. Definitely one of the best I've seen. It was a pretty historical thing for sure.
Yeah,
it was nice, dude. Trump's lawyers are super lawyery, and I love a good lawyer character.
The Jews.
Nah, dude, some like New York shit.
Some New York Jew
lawyers. Some mobsters, dude. Just some fucking Italian motherfuckers.
The best money can buy.
Dude, just fucking. Because it's funny, because there are some like lawyers on the. It's also weird that it's like the Trump's lawyers versus like Democratic stuff. So it's like the Democratic team, which is, I find kind of weird. It just makes it super partisan, which it obviously is. But I thought that was weird. But the like people that are on there, I think some are like counsel, but like at least the lead guy is just kind of a dude who's like on the Senate or the Congress or whatever. So that's kind of interesting. So it's just fucking heating up, dude.
I can't wait. So when is this gonna be? When is this gonna be over?
I think this trial only has like. Apparently, there's only supposed to be like 3 days of it. But I think it started a few days ago.
Seems like it's been going on for years.
Well,
can we just get to the meat?
The impeachment stuff has been going on for years. This is for the removal. So Congress or the Senate, I don't really know, votes on the removal.
So what happens if he's removed? Is it just President Pence or what?
Yeah, I think so.
We just wake up the next day. Is there a new inauguration? Or what?
It's like, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, yo, I'm in this bitch. Let's get Christian, motherfuckers. Mandatory. Every school in the nation has to say a prayer at the beginning of class.
And you know we're against abortion, baby.
Abortion is legal, federal rule.
That
federal
too. Law. There was also President Trump was the first president to go to a pro-life rally recently, which is just for the babies. I saw an Onion article that says he kissed a fetus head, which was fucking funny.
That's gross.
So yeah, dude, it's just on the last podcast we were saying like, what like landmarks of this presidency are people gonna talk about later? Definitely this shit. It's a fun storyline, dude.
It's definitely a TV episode. Yeah,
they're gonna fuck with it.
Tinder.
I've heard of it.
The app.
Yeah.
Adding a panic button to save users from dangerous dates.
I know, dude. Sometimes I get a little anxious on my dates.
Bro, low-key. Fucking
dude,
Tinder sucks.
I was listening. Yeah, I like Bumble more. Of course, because they're sponsored by the San Diego, Los Angeles Clippers.
That's right.
The East Los Clippers. Los Clippers.
Oh, me, little Clippers. Oh, God. It's funny. We have a fun time.
I was watching like a radio. I think I was listening to the radio, just because sometimes I fucking turn on my radio unit.
Whoa, ew. Cancer. Just ending in your room.
And they were like, couldn't you just call 911? And it's like, yeah, but it's kind of like less discreet, I guess. I don't know.
For what?
For like a panic thing.
Oh,
if you're on a date.
Yeah, I think Uber has one of those things too.
A panic thing.
Yeah.
That, yeah. I mean,
let's see what Fox News Live has to say.
Fox News Live.
Date from hell? Question mark. Tinder claims it's got your back. The popular hookup app says it's adding a panic button to help protect users from frightening situations by keeping tabs on their meeting times and locations as they go on their dates and summoning the authorities have called. The new opt-in feature will be offered through a partnership with safety app Noonlight and will be free to use, the company said on Thursday. Match Group, which owns Tinder, will not only have access to any location information gathered by Noonlight. Interesting.
Match owns Tinder, huh?
So Tinder won't have any location info. Just
yeah, I was going to bring up security about it.
When a date is scheduled, the user... Okay, so you schedule your date in the app. That's interesting.
Damn.
When a date is scheduled, the user will be able to share details about the meetup with Noonlight. We'll track the user's location in real time on their phone's GPS. If a user triggers their panic button, they will receive a text from Noonlight prompting them to enter a code. If they don't enter the code, they receive a call confirming they need assistance. If they confirm that they need help or they don't pick up, Noonlight summons authorities to the user's location. The panic button comes after a British man was convicted in November of strangling a backpacker he met on Tinder and dumping her body in the woods, but not before taking trophy pics of the corpse.
You got to take the pic, dude. You got to put it on the gram.
On the gram, dude. Hey, guys, I got a date.
I'm trying to look up when Tinder was acquired.
That's a good question.
Because Match Group, which is like Match.com, owns like basically all the dating apps, dude.
Yeah, and College Humor before they killed it.
Match owns College Humor?
Well, the big parent company is called IAC, Interactive Corp, which owns Match.
June 18, they acquired Tinder. Damn, dude. And I'm looking at Match stock and just seeing a sick, sick increase at like...
You know, it's interesting that... I don't know about you,
damn.
But a lot of Tinder users, when they are getting serious about meeting up for a date before they like fucking actually meet up, they exchange numbers and begin talking on a texting app.
Yeah.
Because it's like, I guess, a better experience.
Yeah. It's definitely a thing where you like graduate.
Yeah. Or it's like, get the fuck off this gross app.
Yeah.
Like, give me a number. And then they realize they see the green text messages and they don't respond.
Yeah, never do that.
Yeah, gross. No woman can love a man with an Android.
Nope. Match owns everything, dude.
Dude, they're like the yum foods of dating.
Yep. Let's see. Vine 2 is trending on the Twitter.
Oh, God. I don't want to hear about that bullshit.
Okay.
They've been saying Vine 2 for fucking years. Even if it comes back, it's not going to be as good. TikTok's just fucking...
The Dolly Parton Challenge. You heard of it?
No, what's that?
You might have seen it. It's the Foursquare, Facebook, Tinder, LinkedIn... and Instagram. It's like people with different pictures of themselves.
No.
It's another like, I don't know, little challenge thing. It's not that interesting.
R. Kelly, emergency hernia surgery, can't make it to
Holy
court.
Holy shit.
Oh God, oh no. This is from our friends at TMZ. R. Kelly missed a court date this week. Uh-oh. But he had a pretty good excuse. Going under the knife in an operating room, not in his jail cell. Sources close to Kelly tell TMZ the singer, who was briefly taken out of MCC Chicago and transported to a hospital earlier this week where the doctors performed emergency surgery to repair a hernia. We're told he was transported back to the big house after the procedure. He was like, wait, I can't go home and relax? I gotta go back to jail?
You gotta get a hernia, dude.
Damn. We don't know how long the hospital stay he had, but he was back in his jail cell by Thursday evening. We're told he wasn't allowed to have any visitors at the hospital. Seems the hernia has been plaguing Kelly for a while. His lawyer filed docs back in September, outlining several medical issues.
How long has he been in jail?
I don't know. Including anxiety, numbness in one of his hands, and the untreated hernia.
Numbness in your hand, R. Kells?
No, dude, probably was strangling all those girls. Kelly is getting pain meds now, and aside from missing the court date this week, He's also MIA from jailhouse basketball games while he's recovering.
TMZ, dude.
Wow.
TMZ with the hard hitting shit. I wonder what position do you think he is on the court? Point guard, shooting guard, small forward?
I don't know.
How tall is he?
Probably, I don't know.
How long has he been in jail, dude?
I don't know, a couple months probably. I didn't even know he was in jail.
I didn't. Dude, I remember there was a... I think that was a fake thing. How tall is this motherfucker? He's 6'1". He could be a nice little fucking...
forward?
Well, yeah. I'm thinking like the actual NBA, Steph Curry's 6'1". But I don't, if we're talking about prison ball here, he's probably a big for sure.
I don't really know the...
Let me just say first... R. Kelly's Wikipedia is just stocked with career stuff and controversy stuff. He's really stocking up the articles. What you can say?
I don't really know the basketball positions besides point guard.
So that's why I was naming them. We can get to it in the third semester if we want to keep on brand with the sports on the three try. But here's a fun fact: they used to not have. Like five named positions. It was just like the front court and the back court.
Mm-hmm.
The back court is towards the half court, so it's kind of like the dudes playing on the perimeters and they're smaller, and then the front court is near the basket, and we just call it the front court. And then some shit happened and now they had like 1 through 5. It's five people on a court.
Yep. So 10 in total.
10 total playing in a game at the same time.
Gotcha.
And then I think there's only like, shit, I don't know. There's not a lot of people on the bench, dude. Maybe like 5 or 6.
Just like the bad players, like Steph.
Whoa, dude.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Heresy. Okay. Heresy. We'll be right back. This is DRH.
Dun, 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 boom,
who this?
Listen a little bit.
Is this Skylar?
No. But good thinking, good thinking. Good thinking.
Is it Malik?
No. You were closer with Skylar.
Is it Echo?
No.
Who is it? Fucking tell me.
Lando.
New oh, really? Out. Oh, damn, that's good. Who's first, this right now? Is this also Lando?
I think so.
Yeah, interesting.
With another producer who I forget the name of.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Dark Racial Humor. Free-flowing end of conversation about whatever's appropriate at the time. I'm Bon Jen.
Caller John David Ricker. Welcome to that third trimester shit. Thanks for not aborting us yet, dude.
Yep, we're almost ready to pop.
We've had a great fucking episode thus far. Little recap. Grammys.
Grammys, Bambi, R. Kelly, hernia? Wow. Shit.
Join us on this episode of Dark Racial Humor.
Oh, God.
Shout out another, Tucson, but kind of former Tucson. The Lasso and Spiritual came out with a song on Mellow Music Group. Formerly Mike Checks and collaborator The Lasso with Lando Chill, dude. Sick song.
Mm.
Shout out that music shit.
Shout out that hard shit. hop into some tech news?
No, dude, you know I love tech news. It's tech and sports, dude.
Fuck yeah, dude.
The third trimester is the personality trimester.
Only things we care about. YouTube moderators are being forced to sign a statement acknowledging the job can give them PTSD.
I'm kind of confused.
So, a while ago, The Verge made this really, really like in-depth, I think it was a podcast or a story or something, about like people that work for Facebook as moderators, and they have to like manually like go through videos of like shit that needs to be taken down from Facebook from all over the world. And it's a lot of like beheadings. It's a lot of child fucking sex shit. It's like a lot of shit that would kind of fuck a person up, right?
Sure.
And they're getting $15 an hour, and all day they just got to look at these videos, and the fucking people like are getting PTSD and shit. And The Verge like did this fucking like story on it. And then after it came out, Facebook like started offering like mental health shit, and like gave them like raises. I guess I think they made like $17 now or some shit, which is still not great for that job, but you know.
You are Facebook.
Yeah. And fucking, well, actually, it's interesting. It's not Facebook. It's a third party company that does it. So
what is it?
I forgot what it's called.
That's interesting.
Yeah. And then Google, they did one on Google, but the difference was Google wouldn't like let The Verge in and like do like interviews with anyone at Google. So Google just interviewed, I mean, The Verge just interviewed like employees. So it was a little bit different. But it's basically like the same thing. Like the people are getting PTSD from doing that shit. And now YouTube moderators are being forced to sign a statement acknowledging the job and giving PTSD. This is from The Verge. They're being ordered to sign a document acknowledging that performing the job can cause post-traumatic stress disorder, according to interviews with employees and documents obtained by The Verge. Accenture, which operates a moderation site for YouTube in Austin, I think that's the company, distributed the document to workers on December 20th, 4 days after The Verge published an investigation into PTSD workers in the facility. I understand the content I will be reviewing may be disturbing, reads the document, which is titled Acknowledgement, and was distributed to employees using DocuSign. It is possible that reviewing such content may impact my mental health, and it could even lead to PTSD. I will take full advantage of the We Care program and seek additional mental health services if needed. I will tell my supervisor and HR people advisor if I believe that the work is negatively affecting my mental health.
What is the company?
It's called Accenture, Accenture.
They're public.
Let's invest. Dude. Let's get in, bro. Dude,
it's shit like, oh, it's not cheap. But shit like that, because I was watching like Match and shit, and it's always like somewhat, I don't know, easy. But you look at shit that rose over like 3 years, and you're like, ah. But it's shit like that where you can, like, you're thinking of stuff or like thinking of companies that could acquire that company. And shit like that, or a company that could acquire something that could do something for a stock price in the future.
Yeah.
And like shit, like if something makes a news with like if that was a low stock Accenture.
Well, how much is it?
It's like 208.
What?
They're from Ireland. It's a multinational professional services company like Adobe House, but less revered.
Right.
That provides services and strategy and consulting and stuff like that. It's fucking been expensive for a minute.
So, yeah, they don't use their own people to do it. They
smart.
Use companies to do it. Yeah, smart. But, yeah, the story was saying that basically AI is not to the point where it can fucking identify all the shit that needs to be taken down. So for the next couple of years, humans need to do it. And they're basically like training AI to know what to fucking pull off.
Nice.
The site. It's crazy. Would you do that job? Just look at beheading videos all day. Just kids getting fucked.
I applied for a moderator position at like ByteDance, which is TikTok.
Really? That sounds awful.
Yeah. It was, I think, an
just
okay
working for
pay,
the Chinese.
But yeah, but the hours were bad.
Yeah, I would not do that shit.
Yeah. I was looking for anything. The guy who was setting it up was a cool guy.
Hey, man, we're so glad you're interested in ByteDance. No, we just need you to sign this document so that you won't kill yourself on the job. Thank you.
Oh, shit.
Oh, it's great. It's great.
ByteDance, dude. Let's get a little bit into everybody's favorite segment with everybody's favorite drop. Dude, it's sports time.
Find Rivers. He's in range. He shoots in time.
Can't beat the fucking Clippers. Y'all make me sick with this shit.
Did that sound
sound a little
fuck?
Weird, but, you know, we're trying our best out here.
It's
a Friday episode.
We'll have to.
Can't beat the fucking Clippers. Y'all make me sick with this shit. Can't beat the fucking Clippers. Y'all make me sick with this shit.
Okay. I'll have to do that later. The Clippers are currently playing on January 24th, halftime, versus the Miami Heat of Miami. And they're losing by 2.
Is the Miami Heat good?
The Miami Heat are kind of, yeah, they're pretty good. They're second in the Eastern Conference. The first of the Eastern Conference is the Milwaukee Bucks. And then, of course, while we're over at the Eastern Conference, we have to see the last place team is the Atlanta Hawks with a 2-4-4 win percentage. Versus the Warriors, 217 percentage.
We world champions.
And so the Warriors are indeed the worst team in the NBA.
They better not fucking lose this game.
We world champions.
See this fucking hat right here?
Yeah, yeah.
I wear this hat with pride.
Yeah, you're wearing a Clippers hat.
Yes.
A San Diego Clippers hat.
A San Diego Clippers
yes,
hat.
That's fucking right.
The first hat I've been able to wear in years. Properly.
Dude, that's such a hat.
It's a great looking
I can't
hat.
Believe
it's kind of it looks kind of old, but it's new.
I wish it was a fucking like a fitted hat.
I want to go to a Clippers game wearing this hat right now.
Dude, the story of this hat. Let's get into it. The story of this hat. I was looking at Clippers games. It was actually documented on this podcast, Dark Racial Humor,
episode 98.
Was it?
I don't know.
I was looking on, and I was trying to see these sweet deals for Clippers, and I see. An anniversary event for the San Diego Clippers, which is what the East Coast Clippers used to be. And you know, I rep SD hard. I also rep a bunch of other shit. You know, Carl John Dobie, Carl Ned Bart, CNB, as they like to call them. Is that they had a movie where it's like a crossover? It's a trip, dude.
It's a great. It's a real cult favorite.
See that there's a very low ticket price, and like I think it's like $15 maybe for the game that they're giving a San Diego tribute. And what are they giving away? A free fucking hat.
Damn, to anyone that comes?
Literally anybody.
Damn.
And you know what it says on the back in small print?
What does it say?
San Diego, dude. I heart San Diego. God. With a sick fucking logo, too.
Where's my fucking phone? Scratch that out.
And so it was acquired. The tickets and the hat was acquired. I took it over, and now the stock price is roaring.
Fuck yeah, dude. And now I look like the flyest little boy in the fucking city.
the flyest 14-year-old.
That's right, man. Motherfucker, let's go fucking flog now, bitch.
The Atlanta Dream 2020 schedule.
Oh, shit.
Was announced.
1, 2, 3.
Jesus, dude. I really. Fuck, dude. I fucked it up.
What? What'd you do?
Hold on, dude. We're going to fix this. Talk about things real quick, dude.
Okay, so the Atlanta Dream, never seen them, never heard of them. But now when people say, you can't name 2 WNBA teams, I can be like, bitch, I can name 3.
Okay, here we go. One.
The fucking LA Sparks, the Atlanta Dreams, and the Houston Wings, bitch.
I think it's Dallas Wings.
The Dallas Wings, bitch. Well, fuck with my Atlanta Dream, dog.
Yeah, we wanted to diversify who we rep, so we hopped on the WNBA.com and found all the poorly, poorly made sites. Like, it's really bad.
It's a really like, bad site.
And they also, the WNBA just got a new player... something play like agreement for money. That's cool, but like if your professional teams have a fucking Wix site, you should just step your fucking game up.
Wix is cool, dude.
A
I mean, you could tell if it's Wix.
AtlantaDream.wix.com.
Okay, no, at least buy the domain, at the very least.
It's they like, have a dot square domain or some shit.
It's though. Like a dollar.
It's fucking just like, and maybe like if you really don't make that much money, like that's some shit.
You should just buy it. We should just buy it right now, atlantadream.com.
Fuck.
Fuck it. Just sit on it. I'll sell it to them for $10.
Find River. He's in range. He shoots in time.
Fucking buy me lunch at work tomorrow.
Can't beat the fucking Clippers. Y'all make me sick. All right, all right.
A little better. We got it.
A proper domain. That's probably the dream.
The Atlanta Dream will play in a brand new Gateway Center Arena at College Park in 2020. They're going to tip off against the fucking Indiana Fever, fucking gross, fucking stinky girls.
The what? The what fever?
The Indiana Fever.
Now I know four teams. Wait, the LA Sparks, the Atlanta Dream, the Dallas Wings, and the Indiana Fever.
Yeah, on Friday, May 15th.
I'm going to forget that one.
Head coach Nikki Collin.
Nikki Collin. She sounds like a coach.
Well, maybe definitely does.
Nikki's are tough girls.
Will make their first regular season appearance in their new home. So I did this with the Los Angeles football club as well, and we do rep them as well. You rep? You're not a big fan of the Galaxy. Fuck the Galaxy.
Fuck the Galaxy.
Fuck the Galaxy. All right,
I'll rep LAFC. You die down hard, the street. Bro.
Okay. And they live down to the fucking street.
Down the street, super close. And
that's another sport news. While I interject with this Atlanta Dream, there's a famous Mexican footballer, Chicharito. I forget his real name, but he goes by Chicharito, which means little P.
My man.
He just signed to the LA Galaxy at like a little pussy in his. Okay, so, and it's kind of.
Whoa, you going to take that, bro? You want to come to the studio and fight this little motherfucker? He's making fun of you. He's shitting on your name, bro. You going to let him do that to you,
bro? And there was footage of him talking with his parents, and he was like, you know, because he was playing in the European leagues with like a Manchester and all that, and he was literally crying, and he's like, it's the start of the end because I'm in the MLS, dude.
Little bitch.
Yeah, and so MLS, he was like,
what's MLS?
The Major League Soccer League.
It's the beginning of the end. It was like,
because it's like the United States Soccer League is kind of seen as like not competitive and a joke.
Oh really?
So he's like, yeah, it's the end of my career, pops. And like,
why does he have to play for them? Why can't he play for someone else?
He was playing in the Mexican league.
Just not good enough, or
I don't think he's good enough for the European leagues anymore.
Wow, well, should have tried harder.
He was like crying and shit, and everybody's like, whoa, dude, we're not a fucking retirement league, and they kind of are, especially the Galaxy, who fucking are lame. The Atlanta Dream, dude. Where's this fucking schedule?
You think it's too late for me to play professional soccer?
There's a Tucson soccer league, or like an Arizona soccer league.
Sounds fun.
Let me download this PDF, and it has no presentation at all. Atlanta Dream.
Put that trash on your computer, dude.
No, it's not downloaded. So let's see when they're at Los Angeles, huh? At Los Angeles.
I'm going to cop those $4 tickets.
Dude.
I do not want to go to a fucking Atlanta Dream Sparks game. That shit would be... Because Clipper games are kind of boring by themselves.
Yeah.
So I know a fucking Sparks game would be boring.
Dude, the first Los Angeles game is in August.
Sweet. I'll set a day aside. I'll put in my calendar so I don't forget.
Oh shit, dude. So the Atlanta Dream, let's see who owns atlantadream.com. Dude.
Who owns it?
It's fucking time, dude.
Yeah, bro. Do it up, dude.
Whodaddy.com? No. What's the fucking... Is it Whodaddy?
GoDaddy?
GoDaddy.
Or domains.com? I don't fucking know. Buy an Atlanta Dream. .com.
Oh, yeah. Someone got it.
Okay, no, but fuck.
It's free,
email them. Make it
off. $3,000 a year, dude.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
That's why they can't afford it, because they don't make that shit in a season.
AtlantaDream.com. I don't think there's anything else, dude. What a fucking episode, dude.
I love it. Enjoy your weekend, everybody. God knows I will. Thanks for listening. DRH, we'll be back on Monday. Peace out.
Yo, shut the fuck up, bro. I'm listening to Dark Racial Humor.